Magandang araw, Kapamilya. Today is Monday of the fourth week of Lent. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. As for me, I trust in the Lord. Let me be glad and rejoice in your mercy, for you have seen my affliction.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who renew the world through mysteries beyond all telling, grant, we pray, that your church may be guided by your eternal design and not be deprived of your help in this present age. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, Lo, I am about to create new heavens and a new earth. The things of the past shall not be remembered or come to mind. Instead, there shall always be rejoicing and happiness in what I create. For I create Jerusalem to be a joy and its people to be a delight. I will rejoice in Jerusalem and exult in my people. No longer shall the sound of weeping be heard there, or the sound of crying. No longer shall there be in it an infant who lives but a few days, or an old man who does not round out his full lifetime. He dies a mere youth who reaches but 100 years, and he who fails of 100 shall be thought accursed. They shall live in the houses they build, and eat the fruit of the vineyards they plant. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
I will extol you, O Lord, for you drew me clear and did not let my enemies rejoice over me. O Lord, you brought me up from the netherworld. You preserved me from among those going down into the pit.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
Sing praise to the Lord, you his faithful ones, and give thanks to his holy name. For his anger lasts but a moment, a lifetime his goodwill. At nightfall, weeping enters in, but with the dawn, rejoicing.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
Hear, O Lord, and have pity on me. O Lord, be my helper. You changed my mourning into dancing. O Lord, my God, forever will I give you thanks.
I will praise you, Lord, for you have rescued me.
Verse before the Gospel. Glory and praise to you, O Christ. Seek good and not evil, so that you may live. And the Lord will be with you. Glory and praise to you, O Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time Jesus left Samaria for Galilee. For Jesus himself testified that a prophet has no honor in his native place. When he came into Galilee, the Galileans welcomed him, since they had seen all he had done in Jerusalem at the feast, for they themselves have gone to the feast. Then he returned to Cana in Galilee, where he had made the water wine. Now there was a royal official whose son was ill in Capernaum. When he heard that Jesus had arrived in Galilee from Judea, he went to him and asked him to come down and heal his son who was near death. Jesus said to him, Unless you people see signs and wonders, you will not believe. The royal official said to him, Sir, come down before my child dies. Jesus said to him, You may go, your son will live. The man believed what Jesus said to him and left. While the man was on his way back, his slaves met him and told him that his boy would live. He asked them when he began to recover. They told him the fever left him yesterday around 1 in the afternoon. The father realized that just at that time, Jesus had said to him, "Your son will live." And he and his whole household came to believe. Now this was the second sign Jesus did when he came to Galilee from Judea. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Itong ebanghelyon to, no, sabi nga, maraming nagsasabi na baka ito raw yung version ni John, yung remember the centurion whose slave was sick. No, but according to the scholars, magkaiba raw because of the details, ano. And here you have again an example of humility. No, for me, I think that's a very beautiful general theme that we can reflect on. No, remember, this was a royal official, and according to the commentaries, he was like a petty king. No, para siyang hari, no, dun sa kanyang lugar. No, but you see the humility that he has, and the humility that was expressed in action, which was willing to go through sacrifices. And then number two is that it was a humility that eventually expressed itself in faith. So maybe yung tatlong punto ng pagninilay, na siguro maganda natin itong pagnilayan ngayong Kwaresma at ipanalangin na tayo ay magkaroon ng ganitong mga masasabi natin katangian or virtues, no, that this may become our virtues as we continue our Lenten journey. Of course, first the humility. No, he was a powerful person, a royal official, and as I said, he was like a petty king, no? And ano siya, kumbaga siguro sa mga ano natin, barangay captain na malakas, ano? And yet, it is this powerful person who now approaches the rabbi, the son of the carpenter. His humility that despite his worldly power or position or status, he humbles himself, no? And asks this favor from this rabbi, no, from this son of the carpenter. Na tinanggap niya, no, yung kapangyarihan itong tao na yung iba sinasabi nga is he not the son of the carpenter, no? And yet because of his love for his son, he humbles himself, no, and approaches this carpenter. And siguro magandang pagnilayan natin, ano yung mga pagkakataon na tayo naging mapagkumbaba at talagang kumbaga ay lumuhod sa Panginoon at hiningi natin. Magandang tingnan, bakit natin nagawa yon? And kadalasan, it is because of the people that we love. But I invite you to reflect on that. The moments when you humbled yourself before the Lord, what was the motivation or what was the inspiration really behind it? That first point to reflect on. No? Number two is this is a humility that was expressed in action. You know, when you take a look at the geography, so to speak, no, this royal official traveled a long distance to be able to reach Christ and to ask him for that favor. So number one, yon, no, the fact that he sacrificed going to Christ himself to beg and to ask, to plead, to pray for his son. That was humility in action. And of course, the very act of coming before Christ, and even though Christ, in a sense, parang binara siya, no? Binara siya. Hindi siya nagpatinag, no? Patuloy siyang nagmakaawa at humingi sa Panginoon ng biyaya na mapagaling anak niya. So ito yung mapagpapakumbaba na nakikita sa konkretong aksyon, ano? Hindi lamang sa salita or sa sabi natin sa drama, no? Pero the concrete actions of traveling, no? Ang haba, ang layo nung kanyang nilakbay para mapuntahan lang niya ang Panginoon. At kahit binara nga siya, even though he was at first seemingly rejected, he continued to ask for that favor, that humility that is expressed in action. No? And then finally, the humility that is transformed into faith. And for me, that is the main grace, no, of this story. Now, because of that humility, because he believed in what the Lord said, this became a conversion experience for him. Hindi lamang to pagbabalik loob, ano, pero isang malalim na pagbabalik loob na humantong sa pag ano, no, pag yung ng conversion. Hindi lamang siya at yung buo niyang mga kasambahay niya, na his whole household went through that conversion. And today let us pray for this, no? Let us pray that during this Lenten journey, we may humble ourselves before God, humble ourselves to ask God for our healing and for the healing of our world and the healing of people whom we love. And hopefully that humility will lead us to action, and also the humility that will lead us to a deepening of our faith. So let us continue our Mass. Let us pray for these virtues, no? The virtue of humility, the virtue of a faith that is put into action, and the virtue of a humility that leads to conversion and to a deeper faith. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Confident then that when we pray with faith to God the Father, He will respond to our request, and open-hearted generosity. With open-hearted generosity, we now present before Him our needs. Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church throughout the world may be a symbol of Christ's healing work by her care for those who are sick in mind, body, and spirit, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That doctors, nurses, and those who care for the sick may show the compassion and gentleness of Jesus in caring for the least of His brethren, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That this season of Lent may be a time of healing and reconciliations for families and communities of people, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us pray also let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Sabay-sabay natin dasalin ang panalangin para sa halalan. Manalangin tayo upang sa papalapit na pambansa at panglokal na halalan ay tunay na maghari ang kalooban ng Diyos na siyang gumagabay sa lahat ng bansa. Sama-sama nating idalangin, iligtas mo kami, Panginoon.
Iligtas mo kami, Panginoon.
Mula sa pamimilit, pananakot, karahasan at terorismo.
Iligtas mo kami, Panginoon.
Mula sa panloloko, pagsisinungaling at pagbaluktot sa katotohanan.
Iligtas mo kami, Panginoon.
Mula sa panunuhol, kasakiman at sabwatan upang makapandaya.
Iligtas mo kami, Panginoon.
Mula sa kawalang muwang na panlilinlang at makitid na pananaw.
Iligtas mo kami, Panginoon.
Mula sa pagbabanta, pananakot at lapastangang pananalita.
Iligtas mo kami, Panginoon.
Sama-sama natin idalangin, dinggin mo kami, Panginoon.
Dinggin mo kami, Panginoon.
Upang aming budhi ang siyang gawing tunay na pamantayan.
Dinggin mo kami, Panginoon.
Upang kabutihan ng nakararami ang aming pinakamataas na layunin.
Dinggin mo kami, Panginoon.
Upang ang dignidad ng tao ay palagi ang igalang.
Dinggin mo kami, Panginoon.
Upang ang kapuspalad at mahina ay pag-ukulan ng higit na pansin.
Dinggin mo kami, Panginoon.
Upang ang pangalaga sa kalikasan ay hindi ipagwalang bahala.
Dinggin mo kami, Panginoon.
Upang ang pagkakaisa ay magbigay daan sa landas ng kapayapaan at kaunlaran.
Dinggin mo kami, Panginoon.
Upang ang banal na pagkatakot sa Diyos at pag-ibig sa kapwa ang maging gabay ng mga magnanais manungkulan sa pamahalaan.
Dinggin mo kami, Panginoon.
Manalangin tayo. Pastol ng aming kaluluwa at tagapagligtas ng sanlibutan, ang politika ang iyong kaloob sa amin. Isang panyaya upang maglingkod sa iba at lumago sa kabanalan. Gabayan mo ang politika ng aming bansa katulad ng paggabay mo sa amin. Nawa ang aming politika na pakikilahok para sa mga botante at kandidato ay magdulot ng kaluwalhatian sa iyong mahal na ngalan, at matulungan din kaming yumabong sa kabutihan ngayon at magpa sa walang hanggan. Amen. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share excuse me, the divinity of Christ who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer. Fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
May we receive, O Lord, we pray, the effects of this offering dedicated to you, so that you may be cleansed from old earthly ways and be renewed by growth in heavenly life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you will that our self-denial should give you thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and so help us imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you with countless angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember, Father most holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you." Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God, behold Him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we confess our sins and we humbly come to you to find forgiveness and life. We come to seek your protection against COVID-19 that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you to look upon us with love, and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and death. Restore our hope and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Bless our efforts to use the medicines developed to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers, that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted, may they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not deny our petition, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and ever blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us. And let us pray. May your holy gifts, O Lord, we pray, give us life by making us new, and by sanctifying us, lead us to things eternal through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And let us now offer our prayer for Ukraine. We fly to your patronage, O Virgin Mother of God. Despise not our prayers in our needs, but deliver us from all danger, since you alone are pure and blessed. O most glorious ever Virgin Mary, the Mother of Christ, our God, accept our prayers and present them to your Son and our God, that for the sake of you he enlighten and save our souls. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Our Lady, Queen of Peace,
Pray for us, especially the people of Ukraine, and pray for the conversion of Russia.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us, especially the people of Ukraine.
Prince of Peace,
have mercy on us, especially the people of Ukraine, and touch the hearts of the Russian soldiers.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Marami pong salamat and have a good day ahead. Have a good week ahead. Thank you po.
Ang Caritas Philippines po ay nagpaabot na ng tulong sa 11 dioceses at mahigit 70,000 families sa pamamagitan ng inyong mga tulong at donasyon. Sa kasalukuyan, kailangan pa po ng ating mga kababayan, tubig, kabuhayan, pabahay, at higit sa lahat pagkain. Ipagpatuloy po natin ang ating pagtutulungan, pagmamalasakit, at pag-aalay kapwa.